this again.
The ground drifts by hundreds of feet below you. Droplets of your blood fall away from you into space. You don't feel any pain, only a numbing cold. Your senses are fading. All you can hear is the beating of the Voidwoken's wings and the beating of your own heart, only your heart is slowing. The Voidwoken seems to sense that you won't make it. It unleashes an outraged screech, then releases you from its grasp. The ground rushes up to meet you. You close your eyes. The woods have grown chilly now that the sun has set. Annie shuffles across the picnic blanket and huddles against you for warmth. You wrap one arm around her and with the other conjure a little ball of flame in your palm. Little more than a party trick, but her eyes fill with wonder nonetheless. "It's so pretty," she says, resting her head against your shoulder. "I don't care what they say, what you have is a gift." She inclines her face up towards yours, lips parted slightly. You lean into her, closing your eyes. Thank you.
Yes.
Rubbish.
Thank you.
junk. Rubbish. Junk.
Hey, look, a lamp.
Lying at your feet is a strange lamp of ancient design. Spots of gold shimmer through the thick grime that coats it. As you hunker down for a closer look, the lamp jerks slightly, almost imperceptibly. The lamp feels strangely hot to your touch. As you wipe away the years of dirt and grime, it trembles in your hand. Heavy smoke spills out of the spout of the lamp, falling to your feet, where it flows away from you. The vapor arches into the air and starts to take shape before you.
Who summons me? What? One of you?
His face twists into a sneer and he flexes his claws.
What's wrong, Godwoken? Did the Seven turn you down too? Or are you here seeking even more power? I should strike you down where you stand, God Taint. Do you think I don't know what you are? Do you think I haven't felt that power? I know what your god promised you, whelp. She called me Godwoken once, Zol Stissa. She promised I would shine bright across the world, that I would right all wrongs. My god gave it all. Power, glory, hope. It was intoxicating, until she took it away.
Deep inside, you can feel Zol Stissa stirring. You hear a faint chuckle. She remembers this one.
Unworthy, she said. Unworthy to be divine. So she gave it to another. What kind of a monster gives you that power only to strip it from you? To promise you will be the light of the world and then cast you into darkness? It was my birthright. They promised me greatness and then cast me aside like a used rag. So I looked elsewhere. The void said I could have eternal power, that I could be the light of the world. And it delivered. I have power unlike any Godwoken, even if I lack my freedom. It laughed as I was sealed away in that lamp. Be the light of the world, Godwoken, it said. Even so, it was more honest than your hellish seven. Understand it or don't, I'm not here for pity from some god's plaything, and I'm certainly not here to hand it my power. You and your gods are a blight upon this world. I would rid the world of your corruption, not help you spread it.
You see the rage in the djinn's eyes fade a little. He flexes his claws as he thinks over what you've said.
Perhaps you are right. I have spent so long locked away with nothing but anger for company. Very well, Godwoken. Tell me, what do you wish for? Do you wish for power, wealth, knowledge, or to see your enemies gone? The Red Prince wishes for the trifle that is the ancient empire. You, who could wish for so much more. No, I do not deal with trifles. Choose again, Godwoken. A hungry mind. Very well, let's find us something to feed it. There are as many ideas in the world as grains of sand on the beach, but I think you will find this one especially intriguing. You have had your wish, Godwoken. We are done here.
speak.
The enormous stone slab is covered with cryptic engravings, obscured in places by smears of dried blood. Half the runes are words, the rest are corresponding musical notes. The inscription is an ancient dwarven dirge. The melody is similar to a popular dwarven drinking song, though the modern version is markedly less macabre. The central rune is stained black with 1,000 years' worth of blood. A relatively fresh coating flakes off in the wind. The enormous stone slab is covered with cryptic engravings, obscure putting childhood lessons to good use. You translate enough to gather that this was a death herald altar. Death heralds were responsible for ensuring that dwarves who did not die under the open sky were granted passage to the afterlife. The central rune is stained. The enormous stone slab is covered with cryptic engravings. Half the runes are the melody of the central rune. The slab remains lifeless, but you sense power lurking within the cold stone. The slab remains half the runes of the melody is similar to a pop. The central rune. Thank you. The slab remains lifeless, but you see half the room, the melody, the central.
Here lies Patrick, prophet. He perished in this place, predicting the downfall of Bracchus Rex.
The statue is as still as the air that surrounds it.
Happening to the shrine.
As the torches around you flicker and crack to life, you hear a low groan. It starts soft, then crescendos until your chest rattles and your head buzzes.
Bracchus Rex! God damn you to this hell in which I suffer! God damn these burning flames! My blood boils in undeath, and you ask if it hurts. The indignity fans the flames. Just when the agony subsides, more come to the shrine and put flame to the torches. They think to honor me. Instead, they incinerate me. You summon me, but don't know my name. I am the great prophet Patrick. I knew Bracchus, I knew his secrets. I saw his rise and fall as woven into the tapestry of time. He branded my truth as blasphemy, and I burn for it. I live that horror. The truth invites danger. Some would sooner be swallowed by the void than tell it. Wait. You. I see it. You, too, follow a path consumed by fire. You must take my gift from among the flames. With it, you will know truth. With it, you can... Bracchus!
The rumble reaches a deafening forte, then dissipates. The voice is gone. Only the whisper of the wind fills your ears.
Thank you.
The statue stands before... The statue stands before...
I've spotted something.
I've got to say, I think we're onto something interesting here. Double the fun. Maybe he can teach us a thing or two while he's digging up that demon. What, this old gaggle of weirdos? I don't know about home, but I do sort of miss the gang I travel with now and then. When you have people like that around you, you know, a family. Even rain feels like sunshine. What, this old gaggle of weirdos? Well, I think I should focus on getting this demon out. And if we pick up a...
See a trap nearby.
Thank you.
Careful. I've spotted a trap.
Go on, then.
Careful now, that's a trap.
The spirit looks out to sea, then to the fire roaring behind him, and whistles.
Pretty cunning of them, don't you think? Light the fire and draw them in. And an effective one, too. Lohar's dwarves light it, ship's captains follow it, and sploosh, the cargo spilled all over the rocks, ripe for picking. Saw a big un go down just the other day. Dare say those wreckers are drowning in contraband. No wonder Top Brass figured something was up. Turns out the folks round Reaper's Cove don't take too kindly to Magister sneaking about. Especially not the dwarven kind. One of them was here tending to the fire. Got me before I got him. I'm a Magister, all right. Well, I was. But yeah, dwarf Magisters are as rare as a three-eyed imp. But when you're hard up, well, sometimes you gotta make choices. Oh, that's mighty kind of you. Can't very well do it myself. Well, you probably guessed that. I'm thankful, friend. Blessings on your kin and your kin's kin.
Careful. I've spotted a trap. Evil lurks here. I can feel it in the very tip of my tail. Voidwoken.
None must pass.
I don't know what...
pursuit list.
Glory is mine. Yield to none.
You will all die!